The single responsibility principle. What does it say? A class or component should have only one responsibility. And someone says, well, I'm not using a class, I'm using a struct. Does this doesn't apply? Well, it does. The single responsibility principle applies to functions, structs, any component. So a class should have only one responsibility. Why?
If it's only one responsibility, it's easier to manage.
Much easier to develop, maintain, test, extend, reuse.
So this is actually one of the principles that I had the hardest time applying, because I just spent so much time thinking, is it doing too much or too little? You know, I started off with writing a manager class, and I don't know how to separate it. I don't know what's considered a responsibility.
So you said you don't know if it's doing too much or too little.
Correct.
If you have to choose between doing too much or too little, which one would you choose?
Too little.
Because it's easier to manage, it's easier to test, it's easier to maintain, it's easier to reuse, right?
Yes. And that's what I try to stick with. And then I have the issue of, you know, I think every developer has the naming, right?
So if you don't know how to name something, you prefer not to separate it and not give it a name.
Correct.
That's why I like to recommend a lot of books about patterns, because by reading about patterns, you gain a vocabulary that you can use for naming your types, for naming your components. Like, what is a service? What is a manager? What is a controller? What is a model? What is a view? I prefer to have a bad name than to have a massive class that does too much. Because a name is very easy to refactor. Xcode can do that for you. But
right.
A massive class that does too much is very difficult to change, because it introduces risk. A change there can break many things, not just one. I recommend making smaller things, because it's going to give you better results.